There's no.
Well, they're probably worry. Like most people. Damn, these guys have balls. They're stupid as hell, but they got balls. Oh my God, they do it old school, right? You know, they're like they don't have any money. You know, and they probably are very familiar with the city. So it was, I'm sure that was like mad respect. You know, for you know, for what you were doing. You know.
And they were just shocked to see us. And we got made some really good friends, especially this one little village, my favorite place in the world, called the Habjeb in Tunisia. Salah, Maslow, Muhammad, Abbasi, these guys I met, I spent 4 days there. And it was just like long-lost brothers. I still think of them as brothers.
Wow.
You know, they were so kind.
Have you ever gone back?
No, actually, I never found that town on a map. I know the name, but I could not find a map with that town. Finally, a few years ago, I found a map that had... I never knew where the town was. When I was traveling blind. Yeah. So I never really knew exactly where I was. I just knew I was in the Sahara, and I had an idea. But it wasn't until years later, when I wrote the book, that actually I knew where I went. I never knew when I was traveling. Because we were just going town to town. We never knew the name of a town.
Wow.
It's always the next town. We're going to the next town. The only town I knew on that whole trip across northern Africa was Tangiers in Morocco and Casablanca from the movie. Algeria, I didn't know a single town. Tunisia, I never didn't know a single town. I didn't know the distance. Didn't know the size of the country. You know, it was just all unknown.
Wow.
What a great adventure.
Getting back to your money, like how did you spend a lot of money in those little towns?
No, we spent, I was so disciplined when I was young, spending money. I'd walk 3 or 4 miles instead of spending 50 cents or a quarter, you know, because I knew this is the money you have and that's what you got to get back. So we were spending about $6 a day. We're traveling, you know, we traveled 4,000, 5,000 kilometers. We had 4 crossings by ship, and we spent $6 a day to live on. Travel, food, transportation, everything.
Wow.
So every dollar was just critical. So we were just, my brother was the same way. You know, if you spend a dollar, you spend $2, that's a third of your money for that entire day.
Yeah.
So we're eating bread, Coca-Cola, we're sleeping outside, we're doing what we got to do. But as we get across the Sahara, we get blocked by the Sub-Saharan War in Algeria. We're hitchhiking village to village, like I said. As we go into these villages, we start getting these words, no, you must go back. Fighting, no civilians allowed. So finally we hitchhike well across Algeria. Algeria's a big country.
Mm.
And we reach a village where nobody give us a ride. They say, you must go back. Pull a cell of guerrillas. They control the only road through. Only soldiers or supplies are allowed into that area. So we're stuck out there in that town. It's like, we can't get back. We can't go back. We know we can't make it back with the money we have. We've got to keep going forward. If we turn around, there's no way we're going to make it anywhere near back. So we're desperate. Understand?
Yeah, but yeah. I'm just like...
So we walk back into the little village.
It's like, no, fighting, bang, bang, die. I mean, like, oh, man. So
then our plan then is, well, we'll bribe somebody. We'll bribe a smuggler or a hustler or somebody that's bringing supplies to the soldiers. So we walk back in this little village. Nobody give us a ride out of the village. On the street, again, we're surrounded by people. People stared at me everywhere I was. People wanted to, like I said, want to touch me, want to shake my hand. But it's all friendly, usually friendly.
Right. So well, that happens in Korea, too, especially when you have hair.
Nothing
the little like, kids nothing, are like rubbing your arms.
Nothing like Africa. Completely different experience.
Yeah.
I had that here, though, too, yeah, but it's just 100 times extreme.
Yeah.
But anyways, we walk back in the village. We ask a couple Arab men. We get across them. We need to get transportation. We'll pay money for somebody. So these two men, older men with robes and turbans, are very kind of nervous. They say, follow them. We don't trust them, but we've got to do what we got to do. So we walk through the market, little streets of this little town, and we go to this little stand where there's this one guy sitting and the owner is serving him tea. And it's an isolated little area. These two men walk up. The guy sitting down, I call him Scarface in my book because he has this beard and he has this evil scar down the side of his neck and his throat, and he's just a tough-looking guy. Hooded eyes, and he got the turban across his face, and he looks at John and I just with these flat eyes, and the two men walk up to him and start talking to him in Arabic, and I can see they're nervous. The two men are nervous. Then the two men walk back to us and say, okay, introduction. They leave. So John and I are in this little area, isolated area with Scarface. So I always sit with something back my back to the wall. I make sure I have a clear view of the entire area. I always know exactly where my exit points are. I can go back this way. There's a way out here. Anytime I'm traveling, you're always that hyper alert, just natural.
Right.
So I sit a good spot to sit, a safe spot to sit, and we start talking to Scarface. and he knows we want to get transportation past the soldiers. So we talk about that. We're not speaking English. It's all written, you know, in signs and so forth. A little French. I knew just a little French, which he knew. And we finally agree, yes, he can take us through the soldiers, get us smugglers past the soldiers.
Wow.
Now it comes down to the money,
yeah, the
tough part. So now we start negotiating with him for the money. And like I said, we got no money. So we got to negotiate really well. So we're back.
With Arabs.
Yeah.
Okay, just want to reiterate, like the toughest negotiators in the world.
This
19-year-old
Yank. So we negotiated back and forth. Finally, we agree on $15 to take us, which at that time was a lot of money. And for us, and especially American dollars. So for the negotiation, we get 15. So I write in the paper, 1-5, on a piece of paper. I show him the paper. 1-5, yes, you agree? He says yes. Then on the palm of my hand, I write 1-5 with a dollar sign on my hand. And I make him shake my hand to have proof, because people always agree to something, and later they charge you more.
Right.
So I have him shake hands. So he says, okay, now we're good. We'll go with you. We don't trust this guy. So we walk to his bus through this little dusty town. And he has a second guy that's driving with him. And it's this big old truck. And they got this big tarp in the back of the truck that's tied down by these ropes. And they put us in the back of the cab of the truck. We're sitting up high behind the two drivers, the Scarface and his buddy, his partner, to head into the Policial Guerrilla checkpoint through the desert. So we leave this little town. John and I are really tense because we don't trust these guys. They might sell us out to the soldiers, sure. You know. And it's a rough, rough ride. The road gets really rough now after we leave that town, you know, and it's bumpy, and we're traveling for a few hours and out of the Sahara. And then finally, Scarface pulls off the hot desert, the road, suddenly, behind this little desert hill, stops the truck, pushes John out of the truck, takes us to the back of the truck, undoes the rope, pulls the tarp up, and I can see military clothing and boots for soldiers. He pushes John and I up onto the truck and hides us under the clothes. And it's just baking hot back there, sweating. And I can hear him tie the tarp. So now we're in the back of the truck under these military clothes, under the tarp, and he's driving towards the checkpoint. So now it's do or die time. You know, we're just sweating it in there. We drive, I don't know how, maybe a couple hours, I don't know. We finally, the truck stops. So I'm in the back of the truck. All I can do is listen. I hear these footsteps coming to the truck. I hear the doors open. I hear Scarface and his buddy get out of the truck. I hear the footsteps and voices come around to the back of the truck. They're talking.
It's a language you don't understand.
Don't understand. I'm just worried they're going to pull up the tarp and point a gun at us. But
they finally
go back. The door closes. The truck starts up. They drive another couple hours. The truck stops. And Scarface and his buddy pulls the tarp up. And we got past the checkpoint. They got us through. And then he rips us off. Later, he ripped us off. He got us through the checkpoint with the soldiers, like he told us. We get to the next town, and he ripped us off.
Yeah, well, you know, consider it a tip. I mean, okay, yeah. Now, that was, so you're still in Algeria.
In Algeria, trying to get through Algeria.